Hello everyone, welcome to the e-learning platform. Children, today I am going to start chapter 3. The name of the chapter is Working with Windows. Children, in this chapter we will discuss many topics. Let's see what topics we are going to discuss in this chapter. First topic is about Windows. Second is features of Windows 7. Next topic is about desktop, icon, taskbar. Then we will discuss next topic, that is files and folders, and then creating a file and folder. Now let's begin the chapter with the explanation of all these topics. First we will discuss about Windows. Windows is a graphical operating system developed by Microsoft. It allows users to view and store files, run the software, play games, watch videos, and provides a way to connect to the internet. It was released for both home computing and professional work. We can say it in another words that Windows is a graphical user interface, that is GUI. It is pronounced as GUI, between a computer and its user. We can say this GUI is the interaction between a computer and its user. And the first version of Windows operating system was Windows 1.0. And the latest version of Windows is Windows 10. Now children, we will see about the features of Windows 7. First, we will see how attractive this Windows 7 is. First feature of Windows are, this is attractive. The use of beautiful graphics make Windows a very attractive operating system. We always like pictures rather than simple text. If a story is told through pictures, that is also called the graphics, it becomes more interesting and can be remembered for a long time. This is the reason we prefer to see a movie rather than reading its story. Next feature of Windows are easy to use and then supports multitasking. How it is easy to use? Windows is very easy. The use of graphics makes it very interactive. We can give commands with the help of a mouse rather than typing with a keyboard. And next one is supports multitasking. As its name, children, multitasking. Multi means more than one and task means work. So we can say Windows can perform more than one task at a time. Now we will see about the next topic, that is about desktop, icon, and taskbar. First we will see about the desktop. When we switch on a computer, Windows starts automatically and displays a welcome message. It is followed by the first screen of Windows, that is known as the desktop. Next, we'll see about the icons. Desktop contains the symbols of the applications stored in the computer, and these symbols are known as icons. Now, let's see about the taskbar. Taskbar is the long horizontal bar present at the bottom of the desktop. We can say the taskbar can be seen at the bottom of the screen. This taskbar has three sections. First one is start button, second one is quick launch toolbar, and third one is notification area. So we can say like this, the taskbar contains three sections, that is start button, quick launch toolbar, and notification area. Now come to the next topic, that is files and folders. Children, First, we will see what is file. A file is a collection of related information stored together. As we keep important papers in a file, similarly, all information in a computer is saved in the form of a file. And each file is given a file name that helps us to find it easily later on. Now, next one is folders. As we keep all our files in a file cabinet, similarly, a folder is like a cabinet where we keep the related files. A folder can hold other folders as well. A folder within a folder is called a subfolder. In other words, we can say folder is a place to store files together. Children, next we will see how can we create a file. There are many steps which we have to follow to create a file. The most common way to create a file is by using any application software. To create a file in Word, we have to follow the steps. First, we will open MS Word. Then, we will get blank page. Then after, we will type something, or we can say we have to complete one document to create the file. Then after, we will click on the file tab. Then we will get one list. There we will get the save option. When we will click on the save option, we will have to write the file name also in the file name box. And then we will click on the save button. Then we can see we have created a new file. So children, to create a file, we have to follow the steps what I already told you now. Next, we will see how can we create a folder. To create a new folder, again we have to follow some steps. To create the new folder, first we will right click in the blank area of the desktop. Then we will see there one shortcut menu will get appeared. Then from that menu only, we will click on the new option. After clicking new option, we can see a list of sub options. From that sub options, we will click on the folder option. A new folder will be created and displayed on the desktop. We can type the name of the folder at the cursor position and then we can press enter. A new folder is created. This way, children, we can create a folder also by using these steps. Now, come to the next topic, that is shortcut icon. A shortcut is an icon that provides an easy and quick method to open any application or software that we use frequently. The lower left corner of the shortcut icon has a small jump arrow. Double clicking on the shortcut icon will open the file or program it represents. Now children, we will see how can we create a shortcut icon for Microsoft Word. First, we have to click on start button. Then we will select all programs. Then after, we will click on Microsoft Office folder. And then finally, we will click on Microsoft Office Word. Only we have to place the cursor on this option. Then we will right click on this Microsoft Office Word 2010 program. A pop-up menu will get appeared. We have to select then send to option. Then we will find another cascading menu. Now we will click on desktop, that create shortcut option. A shortcut Microsoft Word will appear on the desktop with a jump arrow in the lower left corner. We can double click on the shortcut icon to open the application directly. This way, children, we can create any shortcut icon of any application. Only you have to follow these steps to create a shortcut icon. At last, children, we have the recap of the chapter. Hope you are able to understand the chapter, read this chapter properly, and try to learn all the things properly. Now, thank you.